Hello everyone, welcome back to another session of Selenium training. In this session we are going to learn about how to handle drop down on web pages. There are different types of drop downs on a web pages. These are the general drop downs that you will be working on in real time: single select drop down, multi select drop down, single search drop down, multi search drop down. Search means there will be a text box. When you try to type something, then the drop down will be displayed. Until then it will be in a hidden mode. So how to handle that kind of search boxes? And multi search means you can even type to you can select by typing two items and then select those drop downs. And these are the frequently used methods. So when you do testing in real time, you will be using these methods to just get all the options from the drop down, or to deselect the drop downs, or to select by visible text, or by the number. If you know the number, then you can select by index. So we will see all these different methods, how it works. So let's switch to Eclipse. So let me create a drop down. Sorry, let me create a class drop down examples. So in this session we will be seeing about three types of drop downs: single select drop down, multi select drop down, and a single search drop down. Okay, so let me take a public static void main. Let me create the driver instance, system dot set property of. I'm just writing because you will be habituated to learn this when you see the video, right? So let me paste the link from this. I have pasted in my project itself ./driver. So let me use that. So see, when you copy paste, you will be having two double slashes. So just try to remove those. Done. We have declared our driver.exe. Something is wrong. Okay, let us take from here directly. Okay, some lines keep it to the end, to the next line. So okay, now let's create a web driver instance. Driver is equal to, since we will try this example in Chrome browser, so let's take a Chrome driver instance and try to import those. When you see this, okay, we have to give D, it's a case sensitive. Now let's take one example. As usually we are seeing few examples, right? Demo web shop. I'll go to this demo web shop and I'll just click on books section, and there are some drop downs here, right? See, you can see the position, display, view as. So we will try to handle these two drop downs and see how it works, right? So let me copy this link and let me write driver.get this link. Okay, now let us try to inspect this element. Inspect and click here. So this is a select, right? So in our previous sessions, when we are handling the links, text boxes and all those, we are just using a web driver and we are identifying the element like driver dot find or by, find element by, and dot click, dot clear, dot send keys. We are using all those, right? But here for drop downs it's a bit different. We have to write one more extra statement to handle these drop downs. You can see these drop downs are in a select tag, right? So we have to use the select tag, and there is a class called select to handle this kind of drop downs. So how do you do that? Just write select keyword and give any name. So this is sort by, right? So I'll give the name as sort by is equal to new select of. Now just specify the, now specify the location. Okay, so what is the path for this? You can take either name or id orders id also, right? So I'll write driver dot find element of by dot id or name of, okay. Name of, let me take this product's order as the value, okay. Just close it. Don't, you need not write dot click or dot select, something like that. Just close it and then import the select class, okay. Now you are done. So using this object sort by, we are going to select this position, or we are going to select this sort by option. For now I want to select price low to high, okay. So what I have to do, just look at these options. You have four options, right? Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 options, and all these five options are displayed here. So I will use the text from here to select, okay. So we have three kind of methods to do that. One is select by visible text, which will select by visibility of the text, okay. So once it clicks here, it will check for the text here and then it will try to select this option. So how do you do that is simply write sort underscore by and then press dot. You'll be seeing all the options, okay. You can see here select by index, select by value, select by visible text, right. Now I will be selecting select by visible text, okay. So I'll copy this price low to high because I want to select this option and put it in single double quotes, okay. So that's how this method is used. Now let's see one more method. We can see select by index. So what is mean by this index is, you can see here this first value is zero index and the second value is second index and third value is third index. Even you can use index for this drop down as well. First value will be zero, second value will be one. It starts from zero always, okay. Now let's take view as grid and list. We can consider this drop down and let's select this, okay. Now we have two options here, list and grid, right. So the grid will be zero index and list will be one index. So using using one as an index, we will select the list. So how do you do that? Simply you have to create one more select statement for view as, right. So this is a different element, right. And for view as we have name and id. Let's take name and again declare one more select element, okay. Select view as is equal to new select of again driver dot find element of by dot name of, I'll take name, I'll give that price, sorry, we have to select this products view mode, right. So I'll select that and close this. And now this view as, I'll use this view as dot. Now I'll select by index, not by visible text or value. I'll select by index. Okay, and here I'm going to give one because you can see the index of list. By default, it's a grid, right? So I want to select list. Okay, so I'll be considering it as one. Okay, this is zero, this is one. Okay, so that's the reason I gave one, okay. Now let's run this program and see how it works, okay. So I'm closing this browser for now. So Chrome browser is launching. It will launch the browser and navigate to the books page and then maximize the web page. And let's see the options, how it will select those options. Okay. Yeah, you can see the options. It's a bit fast. You are not able to see that. You can see by default it selected price low to high and view as also list, and our test is passed. Okay, so that's how this works, okay. Now let's see an example of a multi-select drop down. Okay, so I'll just keep it here. Single select drop down. Okay, or let me create one more class, or let me copy this. By this I'll just show you how to copy a class and reuse it. Okay, just simply right click and click on copy, and then right click on this package and paste. When it asks for the name, just specify multi-select drop-down example. Okay, now see, you can see one class is created. So by the way, if you want to rename, you can just right click, refactor, rename, and I want to rename this to single drop-down example. Okay, and you'll get some error. Just click on finish, done. So let's go to this multi drop-down. So for this multi drop-down, what I did is I have created one small HTML page. So this selection is also as same as normal select. Okay, so you can see I have different drop-downs: Chrome, Firefox, IE, Safari, and Opera. Okay, this is one drop-down. Okay, if I want to select Chrome and IE, okay, I just want to select Chrome and IE. How do I do that? Let's go here and let's give this path here. Instead of URL, I am giving the path. Okay, so I'll give this HTML name dot HTML. And as usually, how you inspect your elements, right? Just same way you have to inspect this element. So before that, there is some error. Let's see what is that. Okay, because of this plus and all, it's giving some errors. Let me do one thing, let me paste it in different folder. I'll copy this too. I'll create one folder in desktop, web pages. Okay, now let me take this path and let me give it here. Okay, done. Now what we have to do is we have to inspect this element that we do as in the normal web pages, real web pages. So select here and you can see the select name and browser name, and this is given as multiple. That means we can select the multiple options. Now we already have name, I'll take that. So I'll call it as browsers selection. Okay, now I'll give here the name of the select element. Okay, now let me replace this browsers dot select. And now what I'm going to do is I'll delete all this. So select by visible text doc, I will write Chrome as the first option to select. Okay, and I'll copy the same line. This time I want to select another drop down, IE as well, right? So let me give IE here. That's it. You have to write this statement multiple times, whatever this text that you want to select. Okay, now let me run this program and observe carefully. When this program is run, that Chrome and IE will be just selected. Okay, observe it. See, observe, Chrome and IE is selected. It's a bit fast, it selected both, right? Now we have other method also. See, you have different methods, right? So if I want to get options, what all options are there, if I want to get those options, I can do this way. So I'll say browsers underscore selection dot get options. Okay, you can see this get options is dot get options. So you can see this get options is list. Okay, list web element, right? you have to define this in a web element and then navigate and get all the links. So if you remember, we have done tag name, right? We have got link text, how many links are present. See, we have stored all the links on a web page using this method, if you remember. If you haven't watched this video, then just I'll give the description box, you can watch. Here what we did is we stored all the links that are present in a web page and printing those. Okay, so similar way we can use this concept here. So we will store these all options in one list web element and we will try to print those. Okay, I'll be using this for loop and show you how it works. So multi-select drop down, okay, get options, and here I have to store a list web element. I'll say browsers list is equal to, okay, so let me import this list, let me import from list and web element from web element. Okay, so this is a browsers list. I'll replace this here dot get of I dot get text of. Okay, so now let's run this and see what happens. And they both should be selected, Chrome and IE, and then the list of options should be retrieved. Okay, now let's go to our program. Yeah, you can see select Chrome, Firefox, IE, Safari, Opera. All these options are printed, right? So this is how you can get these list of drop downs. You can get list of drop downs, list of links, what you have on a web page, everything you can validate here. Okay, this is how this multi-select drop down works. It's pretty much easy, just that you have to write this select by visible text in a multiple, I mean, you have to write it multiple times for your selection. If you want to select three, you have to write three times. So that's how this multi-select drop-down works. Now, the last and most thing which we will see is single search drop-down. Okay. So before that, I'll show you how that box looks like. So you can see this. I'll click on this drop-down, and as soon as I clicked on this drop-down, there are multiple options, right? Now what I'll do is I'll just type something. So I'll type contact. See, if I type C, it's giving me all the options, right? So I'll type contact and simply you can click here. That's it. That's how this such selection means. Okay. Now let's see an example how this is done. Okay. Again, I'll copy this program and I'll paste here and I'll rename it to search select drop down example. Okay, now let me replace the page name. It's search box, search drop down page, right? So search drop down page dot html, and then as usually we have to do our operations same way. So right click on this, inspect. Okay, so I have to click on this drop down initially. So inspect this element, and I have this as a class. Class is equal, or ID is equal to my drop down, right? So I'll write the same syntax. So let me, okay, driver dot manage dot window dot maximize. Okay, now driver dot find element of by dot ID of. Okay, I'm giving ID name and just click that drop down as a first step. So once you click this drop down, you have search box available. Now inspect that search box. Okay, it's an input type is equal to text, placeholder is equal to search, and ID is equal to my input, right? Now what I'll do is I'll write the same statement, and if you observe the difference between previous selector, previous drop down and this drop down is not a select drop down. It just had all the A elements in a div tag. Okay, now what we can do is driver dot find element of by dot ID of. So what is my ID? My input, right? So copy that, paste here. Now dot send keys of, I'll be doing, see, I'll be giving the contact as a text. Okay, so text, so that is not enough. So once you type the contact, okay, what you have to do, see, once you type the contact, this contact is displayed and you have to click on it. So this is just a normal web page that I'm showing you, but in real time, imagine when you type, you will get all the suggestions of this text which you typed, and you have to just click on that. So if you want to click on that, you have to inspect this element first. So inspect this element. See, you have this inspect element and you want to click on this. So how to click? We have to write XPath. Okay, how do you write that? This is very simple. If you haven't watched the XPath video, just go and watch. This is a simple syntax. I'll call /a, and this is a text, right? We are identifying by text. My text is equal to contact and close it. See, only one element is found. So I'll use this XPath in my program and I'll click on that. So driver dot find element of by dot XPath of, okay, dot h, sorry, dot click. I'm just clicking. I do not type. I already typed the contact, just that I want to click this contact so that it will be selected. Okay, done. Now let's run this program and see how it works. So observe carefully. It will first click on drop down box. Okay. Okay, we got some error. Let's troubleshoot it. So element not interactable. Okay, so let's inspect it again. Inspect drop down. So class is equal to drop button. Okay, we have to use this one. Not we used this one earlier. So but we have to click here, right? Observe carefully. This is a button and class is drop button. So let's change it now. And let's replace this with class name. Okay. So class name. I think this is small. Done. Now let's run this. So identify the exceptions that you are getting and just troubleshoot it as per that. Now it will maximize. It will click on drop down. See, so our script is successful. So that's how this works. This is all about search, select, drop down. So there are different kinds of drop downs, but these are the mostly used drop downs. So deselect all. This deselect all will be used for deselecting all. So let's do that once. So let's go to this multi select what we did example, and we have selected. Okay, we have. Okay, I think we messed up. This is search select, right? Okay, this is multi select actually, and this is a search select. So let's rename it. Sorry for that. So let me rename this to search. And this is multi select, right? So multi select, finish. Okay, so let me comment this. Now what I am going to do, I am going to deselect, right? So first it will be selected, then it will be deselected. So click on dot deselect all. Now run this program. So observe carefully, it will be executed a bit faster. So it will be selected first and you will see the blue color on selection and then deselected. Observe, right? So that is how this deselect all. So there are different various methods you can use. So if you just click on dot, you will be getting all the methods. See, deselect by index, deselect by value. If I want to select the second deselect the second option, I can give that. Or if I want to deselect some other option from this, say for example, if I want to deselect Firefox, I can give this Firefox by dot deselect by visible text off. So these are all pretty very friendly methods. By seeing the method or by reading the method, we can easily understand what we have to do. Okay, So that way you can practice this. So I'll be pushing this code into a repository and I'll be giving you the link also. You can download the repository into your Eclipse and then you can practice these examples. So I'll be giving these .html pages as well somewhere in the folder. So let me create one folder. Web pages or sample web pages. So let me copy these both into here, and you can copy paste in your system these two HTML pages, and you can change the link here for practice. Okay, so search, right? We have to replace this search also, single select. Okay, let's keep it as search select drop down. Okay, so that's all for now. This is very important session that you have to practice, because most of your applications will have a drop down and you should get or you should gain some experience on working with drop downs. Okay, so that's all for now, and we'll meet with the other topic, interesting topic, in the upcoming session. Okay, thank you and have a nice weekend.